I'm going to compare for you cadmium yellow, Hansa yellow, and azo yellow. I'm Sarah, and I make art.
Before we start though, I make videos to help you get better as an artist, so if you don't want to miss any of them, be sure to click the red subscribe button below this video and click the bell to turn on notifications. Just for the record, I'm comparing these mainly for differences in opacity and not so much for differences in shade. I've decided to do my testing against a black background because I thought yellow being a light color, so that would give you and me a better view of how the colors look than putting them against a white background. Just because there's more of a contrast is my thought process behind this. So I'm swatching the yellow light Hansa, the cadmium free yellow, and the azo yellow medium. This is when I had a bit of a surprise. The label on the yellow light Hansa bottle says it's transparent. The label on the yellow azo medium bottle says it's semi-opaque. But as you can see, my swatch, the azo yellow, is obviously quite a bit more transparent against this black background than my swatch of the Hansa yellow. And the azo yellow almost looks green against the black background, so I want to see how it looks against the white. And it looks a lot more yellow. I also want to point out that I don't have anything mixed in these paints. I just have a little bit of water on my brush and that's it. So what you see here is what you would get pretty much straight out of the tube. Comparing yellows 2.0.
So far, all the colors I've swatched for you have been from Liquitex's soft body line. I felt that having all the colors be from the same line was important to get a fair comparison. But I wanted to compare Hansa yellow from the soft body line with the cadmium yellow from the basics line. Hansa yellow is known to be a transparent color, while cadmium is traditionally a more opaque color. But the colors in the basics line tend to have very little pigment, and therefore be more translucent. Pretty much what I want to do here is see which is more translucent, the Hansa yellow and the soft body line of Liquitex, or the cadmium yellow in the basics line.
And I was pretty surprised to find that the Liquitex basics cadmium yellow is actually the more translucent of the two. Just to show you, here's the cadmium yellow in the basics line, and here's the Hansa yellow in the soft body line. And you can clearly see the cadmium is more translucent. Bonus, darkening yellow for shadows. Now normally, the way that I would darken colors is by adding black to them, but I don't do that with yellow, because as you can see, adding black to yellow almost turns it gray. See? Instead, what I do is I mix purple into the yellow, which is able to darken and mute it without turning it ugly and gray like the black does, even after I mix quite a lot in. I'll even do this with colors that are yellow-based. Like, for example, the foliage in the water in this painting, this color, this yellow-green, I darkened it using purple. Just straight purple is great for painting shadows on yellow things. I demonstrated that in my video, Painting Shadows, What Not to Do. And you can also see it in this painting I did of a yellow flower, in which I used purple for the shadows. A long time ago, I made a video similar to this, in which I compared ultramarine blue and phthalo blue. And if you liked this video, I think you'll really get a lot out of that one too.
I make art videos every week. You'll find two more of them over here. And if you want to keep seeing these, make sure to click here to subscribe so I can help you bring out your creativity. Bye!